whom we love from the core of heart and for whom we are eager to listen thought-provoking address, I refer none other but Honorable Chief Justice, Mr. Justice Muhammad Qasim Khan. So, I humbly request His Lordship for his address.
Honorable Chief Justice Designate, today he is not among us. He has full capacity and capability to strengthen this institution. In future, I pray for his health and a long, healthy life. Honorable Mr. Justice Malik Shahzad Ahmad Khan Sahib, who will be the senior Pune judge from tomorrow, my learned brother and sister judges of the Lahore High Court, law officers of federal government and provincial government, learned office bearers, members from different bar associations, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Allah the Almighty in Surah Al-Maidah verses number 8 says, quote, Ey iman walo, Allah ke hukum par khub qaim ho jao, insaaf ke saath gawahi dete, aur tumko kisi qaum ki adawat is par na ubhare ke insaaf na karo. Insaaf karo, wo parhezgari se zyada kareeb hai, aur Allah se daro, beshak Allah ko tumhare kaamon ki khabar hai. Unquote. इस मौका पर मैं उस अजीम हस्ती का जिक्र करना लाजम समझता हूँ जिस हस्ती के बारे में रब्बे करीम ने सूरत नसा आयत नंबर 50 में इरशाद फरमाया, कोट ए ईमान वालो, अल्लाह ताला की अताअत करो और अल्लाह के रसूल की अताअत करो और उन लोगों की भी अताअत करो जो तुम में से साहिब अमर हूँ. The preamble of the Constitution of Islamic Republic of Pakistan 1973 clearly provides the sovereignty over the entire universe belongs to Almighty Allah alone and the authority to be exercised by the people of Pakistan within the limits prescribed by Him is a sacred trust. According to our Constitution, the principle of democracy, freedom, equality, tolerance, and social justice, as pronounced by Islam, shall be fully observed. Fundamental rights, including equity before law, freedom of belief, and independence of judiciary, shall be secured and ensured. Rule of law and supremacy of constitution are two of the main pillars of any state. All the institutions have to work for the rule of law, and in this respect, it is their prime duty to remain within their sphere and never cross the limits prescribed by the Constitution and the law. Judiciary and the bar have to play more important role for the supremacy of law and protection of the Constitution of Islamic Republic of Pakistan, 1970. This is the only way for the progress of our nation, which will strengthen the country to rise and stand amongst the other nations of the world. As the head of the institution, keeping in view the above position, the divine duty is multiplied with administrative tasks, correct plus policy decisions have long-lasting, flourishing impact upon the whole institution, while incorrect decisions can fray the system. When I took over as Chief Justice, I had a clear vision of improving the institution, humanizing litigation by curtailing delay, introducing latest techniques and practice in judicial system, moral and physical betterment of each and every person connected with it. Top amongst these was to improve abilities of judges of district judiciary by facilitating them to improve their knowledge. During this period, although whole society was seriously affected with pandemic COVID-19, but we started training program of the judges through webinars. It is relevant to mention that on my initiation, the board of directors of the Punjab Judicial Academy allowed trainings of the advocates, and for them also through webinars, training program sessions were arranged, and I hope it will be continued in future for the better professional education and training of the advocates. For me, law is deep and vast ocean, whereas amendments, interpretations and new legislation are the way within which the judicial ship survives. If it forecasts these challenges and operates its machinery accordingly, judicial proceedings are best source to understand and comprehend the statutory provisions, best guidance of the implementation of local laws, and best assistance to know the latest interpretations of legislation from the assessment of jurisdiction till the execution of degree. The judicial precedents discuss the backup, reasoning, and logic which enhance their importance for educating the legal fraternity. As the district judiciary from the foundation of this institution, therefore, this fair decision and correct comprehension of law is imperative for delivery of justice to right person at right time. I know that judges are burdened with cases. I always realize that it is hard for them to research for themselves, as no soft source are provided to them on institutional level. Therefore, it was decided to step forward, patronize the research center, and under my supervision and direction, the citations of civil and criminal laws were prepared and distributed among the judges of the civil judiciary. The Honorable Guest, after taking the charge as Chief Justice of this Honorable Court, the first and the foremost challenge I faced was COVID-19. Thus, I had to delicately strike a balance between safety of my judges, advocates, staff, litigants, and continuation of unhampered dispensation of justice. Therefore, decisions regarding exemption and SOPs were issued from time to time. Despite this hard time, I feel proud to say that my judicial officers work with full devotion. Their output remained remarkably good. According to the data provided to me during this period from 19th March 2020 to 31st May 2021, the number of decided cases of the Lahore High Court principal seat as well as its benches were 1,45,053. Similarly, according to the supplied data throughout Punjab during the period from 1st March 2020 to 19th June 2021, the number of decided civil and criminal cases of all categories were 27,86,048. I may add that many of our judges and their families suffered from corona, but I may appreciate that they work with complete devotion. Honorable guests, despite COVID-19 oriented limitations, I did my best to bring positive improvement, and with that aim we got developed and provided computer automated system software for maintenance of record rooms, by which now all records can be found and checked by one stroke. Similarly, as there was noticeable delay in submission of challan of criminal cases, we generated a software for senior civil judge criminal division through which it can be automatically checked that how many challans are not submitted in 15 days and where lies the problem. Other software by which all the registers maintained in the district judiciary are to be computerized will be available for implementation within a couple of days. In the Punjab Judicial Academy, we trained the staff of district record room for maintenance of computerized record. Public facilitation centers have been established at district and tehsil headquarters level to facilitate the litigants for getting copies of the FIR, medical legal reports, postmortem reports, and also to verify the power of attorney. From these centers, people will be able to get complete information of their cases. Recently, verification counter in the Lahore High Court has been established with the help of NADRA for verification of the National Identity Card and Fard Malkiyat. The scope of these centers can further be extended. In addition to above, IT equipment like heavy-duty scanner, servers and storage, internet firewall, LED screens, video conference software, desktop computers and printers, etc. were purchased in very short span of time to establish e-course in 10 honorable courts of the judges of the Lahore High Court as an experience. And I think the time has to come that we have to go for video link arguments. And in this respect, I hope my learned brother, the Chief Justice designate, and other brothers, judges will continue work and we will also enter in the era of the world by adopting all these systems. When we expect best results from our judges and staff, we also need to facilitate them, and with this objective, implementation of special judicial allowances and then waiver of ceiling and grant of utility allowance was also ensured. Many other projects such as transparent promotions and transfer policy, etc., are in the pipeline. Not only that, inclusion of special judicial allowance and judicial allowance in the emolument for the purpose of pension will be decided in a couple of weeks. I tried my best for completion of these projects, but some still remain pending, and I expect that the Honorable Designate Chief Justice will examine and consider the same for implementation. Ladies and gentlemen, I also worked for the betterment, extension, construction of judicial complexes, residence of the judges, as also for allied purposes in different districts of Punjab. One of the mega projects is extension of district court complex of Multan, for which 20 canal lands stand transferred in the name of Lahore High Court with the help of consultants for construction of 10 stories high-rise metro project. The building plan has been prepared and approved. Budget has been allocated for its construction. 6 canal 12 marla land has also been transferred, where parking plaza, ballroom and chamber for the advocate will be constructed at Multan. Furthermore, about 25 canal land has been transferred to the Lahore High Court for construction of Lahore High Court Multan Bench Judicial Complex, along with offices of the Advocate General, Attorney General, Prosecutor General, and also for parking plaza for the staff and advocates of the High Court. In about 30 stations, district headquarters and tehsil headquarters were filtration plants have become functional, and are providing clean drinking water to the advocates, judiciary and the litigants. I was also aware of the difficulties of overseas Pakistanis who are sending approximate remittance of ₹26 billion, which is the backbone of our economy. So judges in the judiciary were nominated to decide the cases of overseas Pakistanis within the parameters of law as early as possible. A draft for legislation is with the government in this respect. To facilitate the litigation and advocates and in order to provide justice at doorstep, I recommended to the government of the Punjab to establish drug courts at Dera Ghazi Khan, Saiwal and Sargodha. Considering the workload, one additional court at Lahore has also been recommended. I also suggested that government to establish special courts offences in respect of banks, service tribunal and environmental tribunal at Multan and Rawalpindi to provide speedy justice and that too at doorstep. And the law department has agreed with the registrar Lahore High Court for establishment of these courts and tribunals. I was very keen to get established commercial courts and for this purpose judges were notified for early decision of the commercial dispute. Training sessions were held in Punjab Judicial Academy with the help of World Bank, renowned legal and financial institution and the scholars on the subject, and I continuously worked on this project. A draft by the help of brother judges was suggested to the government of the Punjab, and ultimately the government promulgated the ordinance for establishment of commercial courts. This winery project was floated with an idea to speed up the decisions of business related dispute with the hope that a resolution of such disputes on priority basis will fetch confidence of business community in and outside the country, and it will result in boosting up the economic growth of the country. These courts have already started functioning, and it is expected that with early decisions of their disputes, the business activity will flourish and foreign investment will increase, especially with reference to CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. I will re-emphasize that we are entrusted with a sacred task of justice. Judges as well as lawyers are equally responsible for administration and dispensation of justice in their own role. So we all must acknowledge our roles are ultimately, we are accountable not only to litigants but also for our own conscience. The voice of the conscience never vanishes. Even if all masses of life vanish, we are also accountable for each word we speak and write and for each deed and act we do. We are accountable before Almighty Allah, who is ultimate judge of this whole world. I also appreciate and acknowledge the positive and wise role of my brother judges and sister judges, especially the members of the administration committee, for strengthening me while taking important and difficult decisions. This task was not a bed of roses for me. This remained an uphill task, but the cooperation of my brother judges and sister judges played a big part in accomplishment of the same with courage, bravery and dignity. At the same time, I am thankful to all the bar associations as they extended maximum cooperation and got resolved their issues through dialogue and not by agitation. I have every reason to believe that noble battles by bar counsel during previous years and in my tenure must go ahead, because if we want to minimize the suffering and pains of the litigants, we have no other options as well. I am fully aware that the Honorable Chief Justice Designate has the ability and capacity to reciprocate in the same terms the Bar Council extended to me and extended for rule of law. I did or at least tried to do what I could do. Last but not the least, I pay a tribute to my deceased father and am thankful to my mother, wife, Habib Muhammad son, Barrister Akil Malik son, Kashmala Khan and Noor Fatima daughter, as they sacrificed to give me maximum mental peace, which helped me a lot to make important judicial and administrative decisions with full peace of mind. I am also thankful to my brother and sisters as they continuously encouraged me in difficult times. I am also thankful to the bar members who appreciate me and who encouraged me for dispensation of justice. And even although some difficult steps were taken, especially verifications of the degree, but that was a pleasant occasion for me when whole of the Bar Association and the members of the Bar Council and advocates of all the legal fraternity and Bar Association supported this decision of the Lahore High Court, and it shows that advocates stand for right decisions, and they, if anything happened against the normal conduct, Bar Association never support them and never side by those persons who use such activities. This was a great occasion. All of your friends were present here. I don't want to take part in any controversy to give any reply to the references, just only said two sentences. One, that most of the decisions were referred to the Chief Justice designate, as he has to work and he has taken the necessary steps. And secondly, with reference to the stance of the government of the Punjab addressed here and the stance of the federal government, I think both are not on one page, and it has to be think by the both the department which stance is true. Thank you very much. I am again thankful to the legal fraternity who support me here and are present here. I am thankful.